Hello and welcome to the course Using PyWeb API from Beginner to Advanced. My name is Vincent Partouche and I'm a member of the support team for OSIsoft's Developer Technologies. In this course, we'll be covering the core functionality of the PyWeb API and practice using that functionality with a variety of tools. Just as importantly, we'll become familiar with the Web API documentation so that you know how to find the information you need going forward. There are some topics to point out that will not be covered in this class. The OMF endpoint that was added for PyWeb API in the 2019 version is the preferred way of writing time series data moving forward. It is an important topic that deserves more attention than we would be able to give it in this course. Additionally, though PyWeb API index search will not be covered, but we will look at alternative ways of searching within the PyWeb API. Finally, I want to highlight that general programming practices are not going to be covered, and the intent of the code examples are just to demonstrate PyWeb API functionality as simply as possible. So what is the PyWeb API? PyWeb API is a RESTful web service that provides programmatic access to the Py system via HTTP requests. It's an ASP.NET web API, and the underlying data access is provided by the AF SDK. REST is a common architectural style for modern web services. Adhering to REST principles in the context of PyWeb API means that we have a client-server architecture. The connections are stateless, so PyWeb API maintains no observable knowledge of clients across request. Each request is an independent transaction between the client and the server. Interaction with the PyWeb API is organized around resources. Most importantly, Py and AF objects such as asset servers, data servers, points, elements, attributes, event frames, and so on map onto resources in the PyWeb API. And it is navigable by links, so in each response from the server, you will get a set of links to related objects. For example, an object returned for an AF element would contain links to the attributes for that element. This makes it easy for a client to quickly navigate between related resources. This slide shows an overview of the three main developer technologies OSIsoft provides for interacting with the Py system. The PyWeb API, as mentioned, is a web service that allows programmatic access for any platform or language that supports making HTTP requests. The PyWeb API itself uses AF SDK for data access, so its functionality is by definition a subset of what AF SDK provides. This also means that it's not possible for PyWeb API to have better performance than AF SDK. However, for many applications, the performance difference is small, and the PyWeb API is much more flexible in terms of which platforms and languages can be used. AF SDK itself is a .NET library that provides the broadest functionality of any of our developer technologies and has the best performance. The main downside is that it's limited to .NET only and Windows operating system only. The third option is our set of PySQL products, which expose the Py system as a relational database via several widely used standards. This makes it easy to integrate with other software that supports those standards and allows for people with a SQL background to easily retrieve data. However, there are limited features when compared to the other two options. For example, all AF server access is read-only. This course is designed to start simple and gradually move on to more advanced features within the Web API. We'll begin by making simple read requests through a web browser, and then move on to making requests that actually change data within the Py system using a tool called Postman. The last few exercises we use Python scripts to do some more advanced tasks like generating web IDs client-side, executing batch requests, and signing up for streaming updates. We will finish by taking a look at the samples on the OSIsoft GitHub and wrapping up with a final exam. I hope you learn a lot and enjoy the course.